Guys, want to see something cool? Hey, listen, I know this is embarrassing. It's embarrassing for me, too. But if you notice, there's two more nesting boxes over there. Okay. I'll get the eggs later. My bad. I was going through the archives this morning. The archives. You see that? Come here. Come here. That bucket, these are junk. Some new handles, some old axes, some old handles, hatchet handles. Oh, the archives. I call this the archives. This is a majority of my axe collection, with the exception of, there's more axe. Whoa, there's freaky. There's more axes in this box down here, and then in the house, there's, I'm a little embarrassed. There's a lot of axes. Shut up! Chuggards! There's a lot of axes. I've been collecting for a while. Long time. I don't get as many now as I used to. It's just kind of dried up in Ohio. And eBay's hit or miss right now. A lot of junk on there for too much money. But I still look when I go to the store. I still look. I'm still looking for treasures. It's all about the hunt, guys. Not about quantity. A little bit about quality. But not a lot. But it's mostly about the hunt. Just finding them things, man. There is no better feeling than when you walk into a flea market or antique store and you look behind some corner and there's that gem just sitting there. $5, $10, $15, whatever it is. It's cool. It's a good feeling. Some of you guys know what I'm talking about. So, I was going through the archives, and I had forgotten about some of the cool axes that are sitting over there, just waiting for some love and attention. But there's a lot of cool axes. I didn't know I had that many. I was looking for, well, I wasn't, yeah, I, what was I looking for? I don't remember what I was looking for. But I know what I found. Check this out.
Right back. Look at this. It's a True Temper Tommy Axe with the nail puller. Joe, you were asking me if that's the original handle.
I don't know, buddy. It could be. Oh, wait a minute. It's got writing. Fire hardened. I don't know if that would be original or not. I'll have to look on the archives. I'll have to look in the internet. It does have a little bit of octagoning going on. Obviously, the head's falling off. I know a guy that could fix this. I don't know if I'd try to save this handle or just replace it. It's so cool. I knew I had one. I put it aside and kind of forgot about it. I have this one, which is, it's the same thing. It's the True Temper Tomahawk Axe. This was in my man cave, in my axe cabinet. Because I rehung this. I used a piece of old axe handle because I wanted a short handle like the Gransfer Brooks. Did I say that right, guys? The small Gransfer Brooks hatchet. What hatchet? I don't know. I ended up buying one. So I don't need the short handle on here anymore. I'm going to redo this. What I'm going to do, I'm going to make a matching set because I just noticed this too. This, the one with the nail puller, is bigger. It's bigger than the little guy. Super cool. So I'm gonna make a matching set. Dude, I'm gonna probably die in this chair. Whoa! That was cool. Finding that was cool. There are a bunch of other stuff back there. Fireman axes. I didn't know I had so many fireman axes and hatchets. Can you guys see that okay? I want you to see. I don't care about me. I want you to see. The goodness is sitting. It's unbelievable. Pluskies. A lot of double bits. I have a lot of double bits for some reason. So anyways, that was a sweet find. I found another. Check this out. I saw this. And I'm like, what is going on with this thing? First off, the guy that I buy a lot of my axes from, he's a vendor at one of the flea markets. He thinks that it has to have a handle in it before he can sell it. Whether it's the right handle or not, it has to have a handle. He will absolutely not sell just a head. And he doesn't ask any more money for him either. That's what's crazy. He can't get past that it has to have a handle. So he'll put dumb stuff in it like this. It doesn't even belong in there. Just so he can say, it's got a handle. Anyway, do you know what this is? Took me a minute to figure it out. I don't know what brand it is, but this is a cruiser double bit. How do I know that? Because of the size of the eye. It was sitting down next to another double bit, and I caught the diameter of the eye. It was different. So I pulled it up. There it is. It's a cruiser double bit. It has seen better days, but I bet I could do something with this. Matter of fact, let's dunk it in some vinegar for a couple days and check back on it. Let's do it. Let's get this handle off. Shake the power right off. Turn this. It's not gonna work. Let's turn this. I'm so glad I mounted this on the steel bench. Yeah. Oh yeah. Let me get something. Need a persuader. If anybody watches, if you guys follow any of my videos, you know that I did a Harbor Freight Treasures video not long ago. This was in it. Here's an update. It's already broke. Already broke. I have never hit anything but wood with this thing, really. It's disappointing. They'll probably warranty it. I bet the camera's shaking like a... Put this back. Firewood. So happen to have the drink. In she goes. We'll check on that in a couple days. Anyways, not a lot going on out here. I haven't got much done the last couple days. There's no update on the Connecticut True Temper registered axe that I'm restoring. I probably won't get back to that till this weekend. Just I have a tough schedule. I work far away from home. I spend a lot of time driving back and forth to work. Don't get much sleep, and then there's always stuff to do around here. It's the country folk life. Anyways, I wanted to take a minute and thank some of you guys. I get a lot of comments from some of you guys, and I appreciate that. This is why I do this. I love YouTube. I'm a big YouTuber. I watch a lot of people. I have a long list of YouTubers I sub to, and I love it when people comment on my videos and the conversation gets going. It's why I do this. I like the really chickens. I like the back and forth. So, I want to give a shout out to a couple of diehards. So, a couple of guys that I'm always seeing in my videos making comments. No particular order. I'm gonna scroll through my comments here, and the names that I recognize mostly, I'm gonna give a shout out to. So, the Weekend Homesteader. good dude. If you don't sub to his channel, you probably should. He's got a whole homestead project going on. He did an amazing remodel. Name is Will. He's got great hair, and he knows a lot about French cleats. So whenever you talk to him, like you make a comment on his video, make sure you ask him about the French cleat system. Jeff Greyer, Jeff, hey man, I'm sorry if I butchered your last name. Thank you. thanks for all your comments and your support. I appreciate it. You always have something good to say. Pat Trick, like P-A-T-T-R-I-C-K. Thanks, buddy. Thanks for all the comments. I enjoy them. Guys like you, keep me going. Joe Sweeney, I think I've seen your name a couple times, man. Keep commenting. Polly Forex. Oh man, where do you live, dude? Comment in this. If you watch this video, Polly, comment in this video where you live. I want to know where you live. You just have a unique way of talking. Lots of comments from you all the time. Thank you, I appreciate it. The offer still stands on that Norlin, buddy. Send it to me. I'll fix it up for you. I'll hang it right. I don't think you have a very rare Norlin that nobody else has. I'm pretty sure what you have is the Voyager. But we will know if you send it to me. I can compare it to mine and show you in video. I'll show you on video, and then you'll know for sure what you got. Joe's Nia, and if you don't, you gotta understand. This is a public. I'm publicly announcing that I'm willing to fix your axe up for nothing and send it back to you. It's not like I'm gonna just disappear off the internet. I'm in too many places. Joe's Neon. Joe has been a big time supporter of my channel since day one. He's been with me for everything. Good dude. Go check out his videos. I've become really good friends with him over the years. I thoroughly enjoy our conversations, Joe. Bartering Bushcraft by Nature. New YouTuber. Great videos. Very talented dude. I'm starting to become pretty good friends with him. Him and I talk quite often offline. Back and forth in our videos. Good YouTuber. Very talented. Look, he inspired a project. It's kind of crappy. I mean, his isn't. His is nice. Mine's kind of crappy. But I saw this in one of his videos. I'm like, man, that's perfect. Because this Leatherman Sidekick, and they come with crappy sheaths. I've been wanting to make something, but I don't want to carry it back here. Because if I CCW, that's where the gun is. So I don't want it to interfere. So I wanted something that was a scout carry and I could carry in the front of my hip like this, like after I saw in his video. Good idea, man. Works good. Bartering Bushcraft by Nature. Really? Are you trying to make babies? Oh, Dallas Ferguson. Thanks for your comments, man. I see you. I try to respond to everybody's comment. It's not really that hard. I'm a small channel, so that's kind of an advantage for the diehards. Because I mean, if you have a question, chances are I'm not gonna miss it. I'll get right back to you. Primal Edge. He's got a great YouTube channel. He makes awesome knives. Lots of leather work. You should go check out his channel, Primal Edge. Good dude. Quagdweller, he comments every now and then. He chimes in every now and then. He's got a good channel, lots of outdoorsy stuff. Go check him out. Thanks, Quag. Thanks, buddy. Get back! Get back, you! Anyways, guys, I just wanted to take a moment and thank you guys for watching my videos, making comments. Like I said, I enjoy that stuff. It makes it worth to do it. I'm sitting at like almost 2,000 subs right now. My videos might get between 100 and 500 views. And a lot of that, I wonder, like, I don't get that many comments. I mean, lately I have, but I don't get 500 comments and I don't get 500 likes. So did they like random people just click on that video and watch like 2 seconds and peace out? Or was that 500 of my subs watching the videos? I mean, according to YouTube analytics, only 3% of my subs. Well, actually, it's up. It's like 17% of my subs right now are watching my videos, which is cool. But I don't know, man. I don't agree with everything YouTube says, algorithms and blah, 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 and this and that. I don't really care either. I'm not doing this for money. If I was trying to make a living off of YouTube, I'd be eating a lot of ramen noodles, which I actually like ramen noodles. I just had some before I came out here. Ramen noodles are my favorite. But it would be the only thing. Well, yeah, it would be the only thing I could afford if I was trying to make a living off YouTube. I don't even think I could afford that. But I don't do this for the money. I do it because I'm not a good writer. So I don't keep a journal. This is kind of like a journal for me that I share with the world. Like, for whoever wants to watch it, I share it. You go back through my videos and just see how things have evolved over the years. It's cool for me. Like, I like to go back through my videos and watch stuff and see where I was at and what I was doing and where I've come from. And it's like going back through a journal, reading your journals, like Boss of the Swamp does. Boss of the Swamp's good at making journals, and then he has them and rereads them. And to me, that's amazing, man. If I had thought about that when I was younger, all the stuff I did, it'd be so cool to go back through and read about some of that stuff. But, you know, whatever, it is what it is. Now I got video archives.
What's up, YouTube? So, I had working on some axes. Recently got into axe restoration. This turned out to be a pretty fun hobby. I got a couple things going on here. I'll just give you guys a quick rundown and then I'm gonna start working. I probably won't, I'm gonna try and videotape some of this, but I don't know how much I'll get.
With a muffin top. Research from the Mayo Clinic proves that people who carry fat in their midsection have a higher risk of health problems, such as heart disease, stroke, high blood pressure, and even cancer. If this is you, we have good news, because women who need to lose 30 pounds or more instantly qualify for a free trial of Sensa, a clinically proven way for women to lose weight all over.
And I enjoy watching them. I enjoy going back through and watching them, and I enjoy sharing this stuff with you guys. I enjoy fixing up these axes. I just want to say thanks. Thanks for taking time to watch my silly little videos. It means a lot. Buck and Billy Ray, I saw you chiming in on my last video. You sneaky dog. You're watching my videos, aren't you? That's fine. I'll watch your videos, so. Good dude. You guys don't know who Buck and Billy Ray is, and you probably do. Like, I can't imagine anybody not knowing who Buck and Billy Ray is. You gotta get over to his channel. Yeah, see what's going down there. Man, that dude's got some energy. I wish I had, like, an ounce of that energy that he's got. Because I just feel like I'm tired all the time. That dude's, like, shot out of a cannon, like, ah! He wakes up in the morning with an axe in his hand. He's like, I'm ready to bang some wedges. So yeah, Buck and Billy Ray, thanks, man, for commenting on my last video. So I was doing some comparison last night, or this morning, when I got home from work. I was out here admiring this Kelly Registered, Connecticut. I was admiring my work, and this is a Collins Connecticut that I hung not long ago, and I'm not happy with this at all. Like, the handle wasn't a good choice to begin with, but it's what I had, and I was like, I'll settle for that. Big mistake. Nothing turned out. I didn't get hardly any shoulder here. That's no good. The wedge looks like crap. And then the Fawn's foot's just like non-existent. That's like nothing. Now, honestly, I haven't finished shaping this handle. But I'm not going to add wood to this to make a Fawn's foot. It's never going to be a good Fawn's foot. And I'm never going to be happy with that shoulder. That's not... I'm capable of better. This is better. That's a good shoulder. You notice it's not sitting above the shoulder, it's sitting on the shoulder, and it has a nice wide shoulder. I see a lot of axes hung above the shoulder. They're too high. You got too much room between the bottom of the shoulder and the bottom of the axe. You got to get it down on that shoulder. The shoulder can be tall, but the head needs to be seated in that shoulder, because this is back in the bottom of that axe eye. So that's a good shoulder. This isn't mine. I want it to be. It's super cool. But this one is. And I'm not going to settle for this. I'm going to redo this. This isn't good enough for me. I'm going to take this handle off. I don't really care if I save it, because like I said, the Fawn's foot's just a crappy Fawn's foot. So I'll be redoing this one soon. Because man, this thing is nice. You know what I'm saying? Like, this thing is nice. I don't know what I'm going to do next. I got to finish this project. I have to get this done. This guy's waiting for this thing. But I have to sharpen it. I have to get some leather made for a sheath and a collar. And then get it shipped back to him so he can put it to use. Have some fun with it. So I don't know what project I'm going to do next. I don't know where I'm going. I have a couple other things that I want to get done. The Council Tool Saddle Axe. I talked about that axe. Doing the Nussmuck Challenge. So I'm hoping to get into some camping soon. Like, I hate to say that because it's hard for me to go camping. But I do love camping. Or bushcrafting. So anyways, I need to get that. I mean, it's usable now. I could take it right now and use it. There's no problem. But I want to make it mine. So I need to get that project done. So that might be coming up. I want to get this King Cutter finished up. And then we'll move on to some other stuff. Leave a comment below if you guys want to see something. I'll see if I can make a video on it. If there's any techniques or anything you want to... Yeah, whatever. But that's pretty much it. We'll call this Axe Vlog number 2. I don't know where I'm going with this, if I keep doing Axe Vlogs or not, but I don't know. If you guys keep watching them, I'll keep putting them up. Chuggabs! Hey, Joe. You didn't expect the green gloves, did you? You must apply boiling seal to your axe handles after they've been properly hung for 1 day every day for a week, then 1 week for a month, then 1 month for a year. And then you will have proper coverage on your axe handles.
That's it, video's over.